Dear friends, welcome to another video. Today we are going to learn how to get the data that this Xiaomi temperature and humidity monitor transmits using the Bluetooth functionality of the ESP32 port. There is a lot to cover, so let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects. In this channel, I share everything about the projects I build to help you develop similar projects or inspire you to start making things because it is easy, fun and creative. Subscribe to the channel now if you don't want to miss any future video. Let's see what we are going to build today. As you can see, I am using an ESP32 board and a 2.8-inch color TFT display I reviewed a few weeks ago. On the display, we display the temperature and the humidity. The cool thing is that I haven't connected any sensors to the ESP32 board at all. I get the temperature and the humidity wirelessly from this commercial Xiaomi temperature and humidity monitor. How cool is that? The display on the Xiaomi device is updated every seconds, but I update a display that is connected to the ESP32 board every 10 seconds to conserve power on the Xiaomi device. This cool Xiaomi temperature and humidity sensor displays the temperature and the humidity on its LCD display, and it can also transmit the data to other Xiaomi devices or apps using the Bluetooth protocol. The device uses a single AAA battery, and since it is a commercial product, the battery life of the device is excellent. It can last on a single AAA battery for months, something we can't achieve on our do-it-yourself projects. A few weeks ago, I discovered that some clever guys managed to reverse engineer the protocol that Xiaomi uses to transmit the data from the sensor and managed to get the data using an ESP32 port. So I tried it, and as you can see, it works. Let's now see how to build this project. We need an ESP32 board, of course, a 2.8-inch ILI 9341 display, the Xiaomi temperature and humidity sensor, a breadboard and some wires. You can find links to all the parts I use in the description of the video below. First, we have to connect the ESP32 board to the 2.8-inch display according to this schematic diagram. I am using this Do-It ESP32 board, which was released about 2 years ago. This version of the board is no longer available, since there is now a newer version of it available which offers more pins, this one. The only reason I am using the old version of the board is that the ground pin of the board is placed next to the HPI pins, at the same side of the board, which makes it breadboard friendly. After connecting the display to the board, we can power up the project. After a few seconds, we receive live data from the nearby Xiaomi device. Since the device uses Bluetooth 4, the range of it is pretty good. We can easily get the data this device transmits from distances up to 10 meters or more. We can also receive the battery level of the Xiaomi device, but I don't display this value on the screen. If we use this USB meter, we can see that the current draw of this project is around 120 to 150 milliamps using this big display. If we use any paper display, put the ESP32 board in deep sleep mode and get data from the sensor every few minutes, we can make this project battery friendly. I will try this in a future video. This project is just a demonstration that we can get data from this device wirelessly. Let's now see the software side of the project. The code of the project is based on this project. I used the code which gets the data from the Xiaomi device and built a standalone project with it. In this variable, we declare that we need to get fresh data every 10 seconds. Here, we declare that we want to display the temperature in degrees Celsius. If you want to use the imperial system, just set this variable to false. At the setup function, we initialize the display and the Bluetooth module of the ESP32 board, and then we draw the user interface on the screen. Next, we search for Bluetooth devices nearby every 10 seconds. We don't make a connection to the Xiaomi device since it is not needed. We only scan for nearby Bluetooth low energy peripherals and check the broadcast advertisement packets. The humidity and temperature values are stored in those packets, so we only need to read them. After we read the value, we display them on the screen. As always, you can find a link to the code of this project in the description of the video below. Now that we know how to get data wirelessly from this sensor, we can build a complete battery-powered weather station. Since this Xiaomi device is a commercial product, it offers great battery life. Unfortunately, we can't achieve similar battery consumption on our projects yet. So, I plan to use this sensor as an outdoor sensor for a weather station project which will use a big e-paper display. It will be cool. Also, I'm going to search for other Xiaomi Bluetooth-enabled devices that we can hack in a similar way. Stay tuned! I would love to know your opinion about this project. Do you find it useful that we can get data from some commercial Bluetooth devices? What are you going to build using this functionality? I would like to read your ideas, so please post them in the comment section below. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects twice a month. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. I'll see you in the next video.